One does not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Food for Soul and Goa Co-working present today's readings and reflection.
August 1st, 2021, 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time.
A reading from the Book of Exodus. The whole Israelite community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them, to see whether they follow my instructions or not. I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God." In the evening quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning a dew lay all about the camp, and when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoarfrost on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, "What is this?" For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, "This is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat." The word of the Lord.
Declare to the generations to come the glorious deeds of the Lord and his strength and the wonders that he wrought. The Lord gave them bread from heaven. He commanded the skies above and opened the doors of heaven. He rained manna upon them for food and gave them heavenly bread. The Lord gave them bread from heaven. Man ate the bread of angels, food he sent them in abundance, and he brought them to his holy land, to the mountains his right hand had won. The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I declare and testify in the Lord that you must no longer live as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. That is not how you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard of him and were taught in him, as truth is in Jesus, that you should put away the old self of your former way of life, corrupted through deceitful desires, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on the new self, created in God's way, in righteousness and holiness of truth. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. One does not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, They themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered them and said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father, God, has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." So they said to him, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, 'He gave them bread from heaven to eat.'" So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Reflection on today's readings by Bob. God is the giver of the bread of life. God sustains people with that which is necessary for their life journey. Our first reading recalls how God provides manna for the Israelites as they journey through the desert on their way to the promised land. Psalm 78, which is the history of the chosen people, focuses today on the same event as the reading from Exodus. In the letter to the Ephesians, St. Paul urges the faithful to put away their old ways and put on the new self, that of being righteous in God's eyes. As we continue the Bread of Life chapter in John's Gospel, the people who have been fed at the multiplication of the loaves, last Sunday's Gospel, ask Jesus questions which show they have missed the point of his teaching and his signs, miracles. Jesus leads the dialogue by telling the people the point of all he does is God's giving them the true bread of life. The first reading is part of the reading from Wednesday of the 16th week, July 21, 2021. It takes place just 1 month after the Exodus from Egypt. By now, the food that the Israelites had taken from Egypt is depleted. They begin to complain to Moses, and God, that when they were slaves in Egypt, they at least had food to eat. Now they are not sure from where their next meal is going to come. They seem to have forgotten how God worked mighty signs and wonders, the 10 plagues, the parting of the sea, the destruction of the Egyptian army, all within the last few months. Even in the midst of their complaints, God has compassion on them and shows divine providence by providing manna and quail to eat. Manna was a flour-like substance that appeared every day on the surface of the desert of Sin, a name associated with Mount Sinai, not called that because of the grumbling of the Israelites, although their grumbling could be considered sin in our understanding. Manna was able to be made into bread.
The Jerome Biblical Commentary comments on the manna. The manna is a honeydew excretion produced by two species of scale insect that infest the tamarisk thickets of the area, which, in fact, have gained the technical name Tamarix manifera. Tamarisk-bearing manna. From the leaves of the thicket, the substance drops to the ground, where it becomes somewhat firm in the cool night air of the desert. It has, however, a low melting point, 70 degrees Fahrenheit, and hence must be gathered by 8:30 a.m. before the sun causes it to melt. To the Bedouins who still roam the area, it remains a delicacy because of its sweet taste.
The word is often associated with the Aramaic word, man, which is a question, interrogative, word, expressing meaning what the, or what is it? Gee, what is miraculous is not that manna appears, but that the quantities of it which is present throughout the four seasons of the year and for the many years of the Israelites' journey through the desert. The responsorial psalm relates the same events as in the first reading. We hear about the people raising their discontent against God and God providing for them with bread, manna, and flesh of birds. Evident is God's care in spite of the people's careless attitude toward God. In our second reading, Paul addresses the Christians at Ephesus. He wants them to put aside their old outward attire and be clothed anew. He seems to be referring to the baptismal rite when people discarded their old clothing, were plunged into the water, and, as they rose from the baptismal water, were clothed with a white garment which symbolized their new relationship with Jesus. In the Gospel today, after walking on the water and calming the sea which was tossing the disciples around in their boat, Jesus arrives on shore. The crowds, who had been fed the previous day during the multiplication of the loaves, are awaiting as Jesus disembarks. They want to know how he arrived there, since they did not see him leaving the boat when his disciples had left. He responds to their questions by telling them they are asking the wrong question, because they are more interested in his works, signs, miracles, than in what the signs signify. They want to be miracle workers like Jesus, not proclaimers of the good news of Jesus. They ask how they can do the same work as he is doing. Jesus remarks that his work is to be faithful to the one who sent him. They once again miss the point and want to see more of his signs, miracles. They recall how Moses worked marvelous signs, including producing bread in the desert. Jesus reminds them that it was not Moses who provided food, it was his Abba Father who performed the great work of feeding the people during the sojourn in the desert. Jesus continues by saying that God still provides food. Once again, the crowd is oblivious to what Jesus is talking about. Jesus has to explain to them that he is the bread of life. Believing in him is what nourishes individuals and gives them the wherewithal to survive every day. As I reflect on the readings, two thoughts strike me. 1. God is the great provider or bread producer, and 2. How often I miss the point of what God is trying to communicate to me. Being the great provider or a bread producer is much more than making sure there is a loaf of bread on the table. We often say that the one who earns money for a family is the bread earner or breadwinner. Bread can mean not only loaves baked from wheat or other grains. Bread is the daily staple on which a person or a group survives. Bread also is a slang for money or the means for providing for oneself and others. God is the bread producer in many ways. First of all, God created the world and continues to allow food to be grown for consumption. God is also the one on whom we rely to nourish us each day, as we say in the Lord's Prayer. That nourishment is not just the food for our stomachs, but anything and everything that keeps us going physically, mentally, emotionally, and, most importantly, spiritually. And a key thing about bread is it is the usual, ordinary, and daily supply of nourishment as opposed to the unusual, special, and only occasional supply. God gives us what we need to survive each and every day. The second point I ponder is that of how often I get sidetracked from the key message God wants me to know. I, like the crowd in the gospel, am struck by certain aspects of God's action, but miss the most important. I may be wowed by the extraordinary or miraculous, but miss God's touching of my life on a daily basis. I follow a line of thinking which leads me away from God rather than toward God. I want to be shown signs of God's presence and action in my life, and I miss the fact that God is always present each and every moment of every day. I seek being fed with the extravagant type of nourishment I want rather than the type of nourishment I need for daily existence. Jesus, the Master Teacher, is speaking as much to me today as he did to the crowds on the shore of the Sea of Galilee. Jesus' words, "This is the work of God, have faith in the one whom God has sent," is what I should be focusing on. I must trust that God is being made known in and through Jesus, and I need only rely on Jesus for my daily sustenance. If we can keep our eyes focused on the Master Teacher, then we will be able to respond with the psalmist today, "What we have heard and know, and what our ancestors have declared to us, we will not hide from their children, we will declare to the generations to come, the glorious deeds of the Lord and God's strength, and the wonders that God has wrought. The personal question, action for today. Do I sometimes miss God's point because I am so caught up in events which wow me, or because I am looking for God to do something miraculous for me? Do I trust God enough to realize that the Lord Jesus always provides for me and others? How can I put more faith in the one whom God has sent, Jesus, first and foremost, but also the other ambassadors of the good news? How can I be an instrument that the Lord Jesus uses to bring the good news to others today, this week, this year? Let us pray. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, through your goodness you have provided daily food for our existence. Not only have you given us that which nourishes our bodies, but you have bestowed on us food for our minds and souls, especially in and through Jesus, your Son, the bread of life. For the times we have missed the mark and sought nourishment in sources in opposition to your plan, we seek your pardon and forgiveness. Through the continued outpouring of your Holy Spirit, help us to stay focused on that food which satisfies the longing of our bodies, souls, and minds. May we continue to trust in your goodness, especially as revealed in the life, teaching, ministry, death, and resurrection of Jesus. We make this prayer in the name of Jesus, your Son, the bread of life, the daily nourishment of our existence, the Master Teacher and Savior, who is living and reigning with you and the Holy Spirit, our one and only God, forever and ever. Amen. Presented by Father Frankie Fernandez, OFM Capuchin. Justice, peace, integrity, creation, JPIC, Capuchin Goa.